sons lay down in sweet heaven. The stars in the bright sky look down where he lay. The living Lord Jesus asleep on the
from heaven's all gracious King.
with peaceful wings unfurled, and still the heavenly music floats o'er all the weary world. Above its sad and lonely plains, they've been on hovering there. Blessed angels sing, and you beneath life's crushing load, whose forms are bending low, who toil along and golden hours come swiftly on the way. Oh, rest beside the weary road and hear the angels sing. Hasting on, and prophets long foretold, with when the ever circling years come proud age of gold, when peace shall over all the earth its ancient splendors fade, and all
of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and in the bonds of charity, and so in the joy of your house delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision, saying, "Fear not, Abram, I am your shield. I will make your reward very great." But Abram said, "O Lord God, what good will your gifts be if I keep on being childless and have as my heir the steward of my house, Eliezer?" Abram continued, "See, you have given me no offspring, and so one of my servants will be my heir." Then the word of the Lord came to him, "No, that one shall not be your heir. your own issue shall be your heir. The Lord took Abram aside outside and said, look up at the sky and count the stars if you can. Just so, he added, shall your descendants be. Abram put his faith in the Lord, who credited it to him as an act of righteousness. The Lord took note of Sarah, as he had said he would, and did for her as he had promised. Sarah became pregnant and bore Abraham a son in his old age, and set the time that God had stated. Abraham gave the name Isaac to his son of his whom Sarah bore him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Everyone?
The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name. Make known among the nations his deeds. Sing to him, sing his praise. Proclaim all his wondrous deeds. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Glory in his holy name. Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Look to the Lord in his strength. Constantly seek his face. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones. He, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for a thousand generations, which he entered into with Abraham, and by his oath to Isaac. The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, by faith Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. He went out not knowing where he was to go. By faith he received power to generate, even though he was past the normal age, and Sarah herself was sterile, for he thought that no one who had made the promise was trustworthy. So it was there that came forth from one man, himself as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and as countless as the sands on the seashore. By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was ready to offer his only son, of whom it was said, through Isaac, descendants shall bear your name. He reasoned that God was able to raise even from the dead, and he received Isaac back as a symbol. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Purification according to the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, just as it is written in the law of the Lord, every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in the sight of all the peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and glory for your people Israel." The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and you yourself a sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." There was also a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived 7 years with her husband after her marriage, and then as a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord. Today we remember in a special way, we honor the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. We honor this special feast as we are in the midst of the Christmas season, just following 2 days after the great feast of the Nativity of our Lord. And on today, we're presented with, in the Gospel, the scene that actually does not take place chronologically until much later after our Lord's birth. This gospel scene, which on one hand may seem to fit, but on if we look deeper, it kind of doesn't make much sense why it's here today. It's depicting what happens 40 days after, or roughly 40 days after our Lord's born. In the law of Moses, in the Torah, which all the Jews followed, 40 days after the birth of a child, the family was meant to go up to the temple of Jerusalem to offer a sacrifice to purify themselves, specifically for the wife to purify herself. And also, as the firstborn child, the child Jesus was meant to be offered up to the Lord, to be consecrated to him as sacred, the firstborn child. And so this is what we have here, but I don't know if you notice, it's not 40 days after Christmas that we're celebrating today. And in fact, we'll hear this reading again if you come to Mass on February 2nd, which is the 40th day, the presentation of the Lord. That's when we celebrate this event in a particularly special way. So why is it that today we are hearing this reading again? Obviously, the Holy Family is present here, but what does this have to do with what we heard proclaimed on Christmas Day, on Christmas night? What does this have to do with the meaning of Christmas, of our Lord's birth? I think one of the keys to seeing the connection and why it's important that we reflect on this reading now is found in Simeon's words that he gives to Our Lady. It says in the Gospel, Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and you yourself a sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. This child is to be a sign that will be contradicted." And here Simeon is giving a prophecy to the Holy Family, to Our Lady, about what will happen at the end of our Lord's life, about the cross, about his death. And it's important that we take this passage and we meditate upon it as we have just celebrated the Feast of Christmas, because it reminds us why our Lord came to this world in the first place. Archbishop Fulton Sheen, Venerable Fulton Sheen, in one of his works, The Life of Christ, begins everything by reminding us that our Lord Jesus was the one man in history who was born so that he might die. He was born so that he might die. He was born for the sole purpose of our salvation, for the purpose of bringing us life, eternal life, through death. And that is why today we are meant to, while we meditate on the Holy Family, remember why our Lord came to be born of a family in the first place. It's because we needed him. It's because of sin, because of original sin, we were dead. Because of original sin, we had no hope of being with God in eternity. And Christ Jesus came to fix that by his death. He was born so that he might die for us. And as we reflect upon that, as we reflect on the suffering that the Holy Family would endure, you know, not just on the cross, but also think about the circumstances surrounding his birth. They were born in a dingy manger where animals feed and make all sorts of mess. Not long after his birth, they had to flee to Egypt because of Herod and the atrocities that he would undertake. They would have to suffer possibly humiliation because of the circumstances of how Our Lady was perceived to have become pregnant. You know, all these things, they had to suffer. But it's because this child that was born did not come to live, but to die. And this is a reminder and a consolation to us who live normal lives, who don't live the life of the Holy Family, but who experience similar sufferings. I don't have to sit up here and tell you that family life is hard. That family life comes with it many trials and many sufferings. Whether it's financial, you know, having to make ends meet, whether it's trying to keep your kids engaged in school or trying to just make sure that they have a good life for themselves, whether it's particularly in this day trying to keep up with working at home while also keeping your kids focused on school while they have to do it virtually, whatever, whether it's just trying to deal with conflicts with you and your spouse. Family life is always, the cross is always present in family life. And that's why it's important that we see this today. That just like we experience in our own lives, whether you're married or whether celibate, whether you have not yet embraced your vocation in life, the cross is there because it was there for our Lord from the very moment of his birth. From the very moment he entered the world, the cross was there. And he doesn't shy away from telling us that it will be there for us. He says, anyone who comes after me must deny himself and take up his cross. And that is most true for those who embrace any sort of vocation, whether married or celibate or what have you. But we should be consoled, we should be comforted, because our Lord does not ask us to do anything he did not endure himself. He does not ask us to take up any cross that he was not willing to bear himself. And that is our comfort as we enter into more fully this Christmas season. A Christmas season unlike probably any we have experienced, where we don't always get to celebrate it the way that we'd want to, where we don't get to worship maybe the way that we want to, but how our Lord reminds us, do not be afraid, do not be anxious, because there is no cross I will not bear with you. And that is the comfort that he gives us today through the example of the Holy Family, that we bore that cross too. And so do not be afraid, because I and we can bear it with you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The family of Nazareth inspires us to imitate the virtues of holiness and piety. With this ideal before us, we ask the Lord to hear our prayers on this family day. For the family of the church, that we may give respect and dignity to all God's children, let us pray to the Lord. For the family of people and nations, that the rights of the old and the young will be upheld for the sake of peace, justice, and harmony, let us pray to the Lord. For all our families, that those separated from their family circle will find a home with God's people, let us pray to the Lord. For broken families, that God's reconciling forgiveness will be granted and accepted to restore our relationships of love, let us pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives and friends and all the departed, that they may be gathered into the eternal joy of their heavenly home, let us pray to the Lord. Father in heaven, by subjecting himself to Mary and Joseph, your Son sanctified home life at Nazareth. As we offer our prayers, help us to follow his example, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
angels greet with anthem sweet, while shepherds watch their keeping. There stands his Christ, the King, whom shepherds guard.
We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that, through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Shelton, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them. for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true, celebrating the most sacred day on which Blessed Mary, the Immaculate Virgin, brought forth a Savior for this world, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, but by the cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For those joining us on social media, please pray with me and act as spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come and lead spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
land above the deep and dreamless sea, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. Hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For whom Christ is born, of Mary, and gathered all above, by whom mortals sleep, angels keep their watch of wandering love. Oh, morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the and
Let us pray. Bring those you refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we dismiss, I just wish you, to all your families out there, as we celebrate this Holy Family Day, I know this is not the most ideal time in our lives, but I pray that you can feel the presence of our Lord today, especially as we ask the intercession and the grace of the Holy Family today to pray for you and for your families, for your flourishing, and for your peace. And so know of my prayers for you, especially this day as we honor the Holy Family. As we give this final blessing, we dismiss. Hope you have a blessed week, especially as we prepare for the new year. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy day, drive far from you the darkness of vice and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue. Amen. May God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives and make you heralds of his gospel. Amen. And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor and make you sharers with the church in heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Oh, tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Oh, tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching over silent flocks by night, oh, throughout the heaven it shone a holy light. Oh, we'll tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Oh, tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Oh, tell it on the mountain.